Hey, this is Michelle Goetzinger, and I'm here at a new construction project with Stix Stones, and I can't wait to introduce you to Adam Stickle. Hey, Adam, how are you?
Good, Michelle, how are you?
Real good.
So, Adam and I met about 5 years ago at the University of Pittsburgh Fellowship Program for Entrepreneurship. And I was working with Blooms, our family granite business, and you were working with?
Primrose Homes.
Primrose Homes, your family business too.
A lot has changed for us.
Yeah, a lot has changed in 5 years. All for the good though.
Absolutely.
Yep. Can you tell us a little bit about this project you're working on?
Yeah, absolutely. This is a custom home project.
Okay.
It's 2,400 square feet, farm style house, three bedrooms, two bathrooms.
And
homeowner gets to select absolutely every finish in the house.
That's great. What a great setting too. It seems country, but it's so close to the city.
It is. They have lived out here for multiple years now in the area, and they wanted to keep the kids in the same school district. They really enjoy it here.
That's awesome. So this is new construction. They bought the lot, and then how does that process work?
So once they buy the lot, we go through a design process with them where we identify the key features in the house that they want. We then identify either a plan online that we can purchase, or we network with local interior designers and architects to draw the plan exactly the way they want it. From there we go to a bank and see if we can appraise the house for what they'd like to spend.
And then you have to go to the township, correct?
Yep, then we go through the permitting process with the township. Anytime we're in Allegheny County, we also have to go to the county itself for some permits.
Okay. So Adam, tell us about some other projects other than this farmhouse that you're building right here that you're working on right now.
So just finished up a large renovation in the historic part of Squirrel Hill.
Where
we did a whole house renovation. It started as just a couple rooms. It was actually a referral from one of our EFC fellows. And so that was really exciting. Just about to get started with a renovation project in Swickley as well. And then I have a new construction project over in Hampton Township.
Wow. So what's been your favorite or your most challenging and or both projects that you worked on?
Recently, probably the most challenging project that I worked on was a new construction home in Fox Chapel. It was a very modern, contemporary home, but the footprint of the home was reversed. The smallest level of the house was the foundation, and as each story went up, the house got longer and wider. And so structurally, it was a challenging project.
How did you deal with that?
People on our team, you know, our architects and our engineers, as well as bringing in our trade professionals, you know, early in the design process to be able to make sure that they were on board with what we wanted to do.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. So how did you come up with the name Stix Stones?
So the name actually came from Stix. The Stix part of it came from my high school baseball playing days.
Oh, really?
That was my nickname. and so that's the first part of it. And then we finished it off with the and stones, really based on the biblical reference that Jesus makes about building a house on a foundation of rock rather than on sand.
Yeah. So, oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So we're up here in the loft, and Adam's going to tell us a little bit about some of the challenges that he faces when he's doing these renos and the new construction. So tell us a little bit about what happened here.
So up here in any project, one of the hardest things for customers and homeowners is to visualize what the space is going to look like. What we were able to do here is this was actually supposed to, you were supposed to come from the hallway and step down into this room.
Okay.
But once we got on site, we realized that that's not really what the homeowner wanted. And so we changed the construction of the first floor wall so that we could eliminate the steps into this room. And we also could make the room larger than it was on the plan. So in custom construction, it's all about being flexible and trying to meet the homeowner's needs and their dreams.
In most renovations, that's a problem, right? There's
absolutely,
it never goes as planned.
No, you never can expect the unknown is what we talk about. And so as you tear into walls, you don't know what's behind the walls. As you visualize, you think that this is enough space, and then you get in the space and it's not enough space, you move walls. And so you never know. So you have to have flexibility and somebody who's willing to be flexible.
And that's honestly the hardest part, is setting those expectations with the client that this is a fluid process and things are going to change and we're going to hit hiccups and whatnot. Right.
So one of the things that we encourage all of our clients to do when we create an itemized budget for their project mm-hmm. is we have a line item labeled contingency.
Okay.
And so if that, and what we do is we put a budget there that's normally somewhere between 2-3% of the project.
Okay.
And if they use that money on the unforeseen, at least they've budgeted for it.
Right.
If they don't use it, it's money that they save. It mm-hmm. doesn't go into our pocket, it goes back to them.
Right.
And so that's a way to plan a little bit of buffer mm-hmm. for those unexpected costs.
That's a great idea.
Yeah. Okay. So some of the features that I like to use in custom construction and that we use on all of our projects is the subfloor that we use here is an Advantech subfloor. What we like about this is I've used it for 10 years now and never once has a hardwood floor squeaked or never once have I had tile crack when I use Advantech subfloor. And
wow.
You've been through plenty of old homes in mm-hmm. Pittsburgh, and how often do you hear the squeaky floors and see the cracked tile?
Yep, a lot. Right?
Another feature of this home is we used Marvin's Integrity windows. And so what this is, it's actually a window that's a extruded plastic mm-hmm. window on the exterior and wood on the interior. Why we like to use the plastic is it doesn't fade like aluminum windows do,
mm-hmm.
and it doesn't move like a vinyl window does.
Okay.
So just two features of this house that I wanted to point out.
Yeah. What makes the Advantech any different than normal plywood?
So the technology behind it is there's actually a resin that is completely through the product,
okay.
Top to bottom. And so when you cut it, the resin is still there. There's other plywoods out there where that resin is just on the edge. Mm-hmm. So anytime you cut a piece, it exposes it to be just like regular plywood.
Yeah, and it can expand and contract.
Yeah, during new construction, it's gonna get wet,
mm-hmm.
and so it's going to expand,
right.
and no question asked. But you have to nail it right away, so anytime it expands, when it does contract, that nail becomes loose, and that's what causes the squeaky floors over the years.
Mm-hmm. So. What's the percentage difference? Is it more expensive than normal plywood, I'm assuming?
Yeah.
Is it significantly more?
It's about, so per sheet, you're talking somewhere in the range of $13 to $15.
Okay.
So on a house this size, we might be using 75 sheets of it.
Okay.
So there is an upgrade, but when you think about the fact that you don't have the callbacks
right.
and to worry. And if anything ever does happen with it, this company does warranty it for 25 years.
Oh, wow, that's great.
It is.
Yeah.
And they stand behind that warranty. A lot of people don't.
Mm-hmm.
They had one in their history that I know of, one batch that was not good.
Mm-hmm.
And they actually went in and bought the three homes that the product was put into.
Really?
They completely bought it, they relocated people, helped them find new homes.
Wow, so, and then what did they do with them?
And then they tore them all apart, redid them, and put them back on the market.
Wow, that's incredible.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great.
You don't hear that.
No,
often,
you don't.
So.
And it's nice that you're doing things the right way in the beginning.
Yeah, it's so key because, mm-hmm. you know, to be a contractor or a home builder here in Pennsylvania, there's no licensure requirement,
mm-hmm.
there's no continuing education requirement. And so we talk about at Stix Stones, you know, we hold certifications. We're part of the National Association of Home Builders,
mm-hmm.
and we do continuing education every year,
mm-hmm.
So that we can separate ourselves and so that we can learn about new products, new sciences, and try to stay ahead of the curve on
That's
things.
Great. One of the things that makes Stix Stones different is their continuing education and certifications that they have. And one of the things that fits this house is a program called Aging in Place. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, so Aging in Place is a philosophy of building and a science of building where homeowners build a home so that they can live there over decades.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, this is a family home. We've got children with their parents, but eventually, as we all know, or hopefully, as
yeah,
we all know, our kids move on
mm-hmm.
to their own place.
That's right.
So what we did here, so that the parents still could have everything that they need, is we made this house, or we chose a house where the master suite is on the first floor. So the kitchen, the family room, the dining room, laundry room, and the garage are all on one level. And so when those kids do move on, as the parents get older, this is a place that's accessible for them, no matter what stage in life they're in.
That's great. That's wonderful.
This is gonna be like 4-foot shower,
mm-hmm.
tub, and the master closet over here.
That's nice.
So we bought these plans offline. This was, we found something that he liked and just used the plan from
yeah.
an architect actually out of the South. So
It's a pretty layout.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
it turned out great. So, and you know, little things like making sure that you're, to get the best energy efficiency, making sure that you're caulking the bottom plate here
mm-hmm.
in new construction. And so that prevents air from coming in between the subfloor and the walls. So just trying to do those little things to make sure that we're setting ourselves apart.
Yeah, and I see over here you've also sealed it up.
Yep, since we're not finishing the basement now, any penetrations, any holes that we've made from the walls down into the floors, we're sealing all of those up so that we don't have any cold air coming into the conditioned spaces in the winter, mm-hmm. or warm air coming into the conditioned spaces in the summer.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yep. So Adam, tell me a little bit about some of your biggest challenges in your industry right now.
Currently, right now, some of the biggest challenges are on the labor side. Mm-hmm. Finding really good tradesmen, mm-hmm. people who are skilled at what they do, because it is so easy. It is such a busy market, and it's so easy to gain entrance into this market, mm-hmm. that you get a lot of people who just don't do quality work, or might not know the right way to install products, the right way to meet the codes, and so finding the right team of people is really critical.
And you subcontract all of that out?
Yeah, right now we subcontract everything out. Mm-hmm. We used to employ some carpenters, but we have decided that it's best to subcontract things. And what that does is it gives us flexibility. So if we're building on the east side of Pittsburgh or downtown Pittsburgh, or as far away as Deep Creek, Maryland, we've mm-hmm. done projects. It allows us to find the right team in those communities who know the community well, who know the code officials well, and who have a lot of experience with those neighborhoods.
Yeah. How can somebody get a hold of you? Can an average Joe just use you for a renovation?
Yeah, anybody can use us. Okay. We are open to all renovation projects.
Okay.
And if it's not a good fit for us, if we feel like we're not the right company, we do have teams of contractors across Western PA that mm-hmm. we can make sure you're referred to somebody who does good quality work.
Okay.
But the best way to get a hold of us really is by phone,
okay.
because these type of projects, they need that true face-to-face conversation. We'll
mm-hmm.
come out and take a look at any project at no charge
mm-hmm.
and give you a preliminary estimate
okay.
as part of that process.
Wow, that's great.
So.
Very cool.